सो नेक्स्ट रिजल्ट इज लेट ए बी ए कम्प्लेक्स बना अलजेब्रा विद आइडेंटिटी ई देन शो दैट स्पेक्ट्रल रेडियस ऑफ एक्स विच इज इक्वल टू लिमिट एन अप्रोचेस इनफिनिटी नॉर्म ऑफ एक्स रेज टू पावर एन एंड सारे दी रेज टू पावर 1/n. सो वी बाय प्रीवियस लेमा वी प्रूव दैट सिग्मा एक्स एन which is equal to sigma x raised to power n. So it means from this we can find that the spectral radius of x raised to power n, which is equal to spectral radius of x raised to power n, sare the raised to power n. This is equation number one. Why this? So first remember what is spectral radius. So spectral radius is supremum of absolute value of lambda when lambda belongs to sigma of x, because these two terms are equal, these two sets are equal, then spectral radius of this and spectral radius of this will be same. That's why the spectral radius of x raised to power n and spectral radius of x raised to power n are same. Next, so we already defined the definition of spectral radius. This is a supremum of a modulus of lambda. Lambda belongs to sigma x, where sigma x is equal to lambda belongs to C. X minus lambda is a singular, right? Again, we know that sigma x is bounded set. So what is sigma x? Sigma x is a part of lambda belongs to C, modulus of lambda, which is less than equal to norm of x. So it means sigma x is a bounded. Now from this, sigma x is lies between this set. Then it means every value of lambda satisfy this condition. If it satisfy this condition, then it means absolute value of lambda less than equal to norm of x for every lambda belongs to sigma x. So this condition is true for every lambda. Now this condition is also true for supremum. Then it implies supremum of absolute value of lambda such that lambda belongs to sigma x less than equal to norm of x. So it implies, what is this? It is a spectral radius of vector x. So r of x sigma less than equal to norm of x. So which is equation number 3. It implies if we replace x by x raised to power n, then equation number 3 is converted as in the equation number 4, which is r sigma x raised to power n less than equal to norm of x raised to power n. So that is in equation number 4. Now from equation number 1 and equation number 4, we get r sigma x raised to power n less than equal to norm of x raised to power n. So what is the equation number 1? Equation number 1 is r sigma x raised to power n is equal to r sigma of x and raised to power n. So this is equal to this values, that is equation number 1. So from this equation, this raised to power n less than equal to norm x raised to power n, and this implies when we take the nth root on both sides, so we get equation number 5, which is r sigma x less than equal to norm of x raised to power n or sare din. So next is, if modulus of lambda greater than norm of x, it implies norm of x over lambda is less than 1. It means e minus x lambda is regular, means invertible. So it can also be written in the form of series, which is equation number 6. Now x of lambda, which is a of resolvent operator x lambda, which is equal to x minus lambda e inverse. This can be written in this form. On substituting the value of e minus x lambda inverse, so here we take this is also raised to power minus 1. So correct this bracket, it is minus lambda inverse into e minus x lambda or raised to power minus. So x of lambda can be written in this form, minus lambda inverse, and on substituting the value of 6 in this equation, so we get e plus summation of k running from 1 to infinity, lambda inverse into x raised to power k. This is by equation number 6. Now first, if we take capital F, which is a functional on A, then capital F of x lambda, this can be represented as minus lambda inverse capital F of E plus capital F of this bracket. So this, because of scalar and capital F is functional, this can be taken outside. So this is lambda raised to power minus k F of x raised to power k. So this condition is satisfied for modulus of lambda greater than norm of x. So that is equation number 7. We know that x lambda is an entire or holomorphic function in a row of x. So it implies capital F of x lambda is again holomorphic for modulus of lambda greater than norm of x, or we can also write it as modulus of lambda greater than r sigma x, because this is greater than equal to spectral radius, that is in equation number 3, for example. So in equation number 3, this is greater than equal to r sigma x. When we use this result, so this term, this is a norm greater than r sigma x. So modulus of lambda is greater than r sigma x. It implies singularity of x lambda lies in the disk this. Why? Because this function is analytic in this region. This is a, if it is a circle with radius r sigma x, it means outside the circle this function is holomorphic. If it has any kind of singularity, so that lies inside the circle. It means if, hence the singularities of this function lies in the disk inside the circle. So modulus of lambda less than equal r sigma x inside and on the boundary. So it implies this series is convergent for this function where it is analytic. If this is this series is convergent for this condition, therefore the term of sequence form a bounded sequence. So it's nth term, which is f of lambda inverse x raised to power k, so which form a bounded sequence, that form a bounded sequence. So by uniform bounded principle, L lambda inverse k into x raised to power k form a bounded sequence. If it form a bounded sequence, that is by using the bounded principle. Now what is the that statement that we are using here? A non-empty subset S of non-linear space N is bounded if and only if F of S is bounded set for every functional. It means if capital F of this is bounded, this, then this term is also bounded by using principle of uniform principle of uniform bounded principle. So it means lambda raised to power minus k x raised to power k form a bounded sequence, if it form a bounded sequence. So this can be written in this form, this is less than infinity, and norm of x raised to power n less than equal to capital M into modulus of lambda raised to power n. So taking nth root on both sides, so this value is less than equal to this constant, which is less than 1. So the entire value is less than equal to absolute value of lambda. So it implies, since lambda is arbitrary, so it implies when we take the supremum of this absolute value, so this means limit n approaches infinity, norm of x raised to power n and power of 1 by n less than equal to r sigma x. This is a equation number 8. Now from equation number 5 and 8, we get limit n approaches infinity, norm of x n, norm raised to power 1 by n, which is equal to r sigma x. So this result is very important. Now this is the end of Banach algebra. So thank you very much.